Hi folks, this is David Atunquan here, and this video I wanted to talk about, well, bombing. That's kind of been going on, but it's just a topic of bombing with airplanes, with drones. I think it's a very important topic to talk about, and especially relevant currently as, you know, United States has started a aerial bombing campaign, or what do they call it? A strategic airstrike? I don't know what, it's not war. Apparently, but that's kind of been the whole rhetoric of this airstrikes and bombing and whatnot. But even that, I think it's something to seriously consider. I have a simple thought, but I think it's a powerful thought. And the simple thought is bombing kills, and it hurts. It causes pain and suffering. That's the simple thought. You know, I just want to leave with that kind of thought, like every day that this is going on. And I think it's a powerful thought, and it can be really easily overlooked. You know, when we as a people, we kind of start talking about, oh, terrorists this, and then there's like these evil people, you know, let's just bomb the hell out of them, let's bomb those terrorists. That kind of statement is really easy to say. It's not like every time we say that, you know, we get images in our mind of what actually happens. And what actually happens when you bomb people, you know, you should get an image of rubbles of buildings that are bloodied, limbs that are disfigured, you know, arms flying everywhere, and burnt corpses and screaming and everything. That's the image of a bombing. But it's not like we picture that every time we say, let's bomb those terrorists. But that's actually what happens after the bombs drop and explode. It's not a fancy explosion that you see in movies and video games. There's that too, but the aftermath is a bunch of dead bodies, you know, stuck in rubbles. There are a lot of screaming and in between slabs of concrete, the loud, terrifying sirens of ambulances and fire trucks. And then there's the observers that are kind of terrified and gasping. You know how when there was that Boston bombing marathon done in the United States and Americans kind of freaked out? Well, that's the reality of many parts every day. In other parts of the world, that's even worse. Well, imagine Boston bombing, but imagine it like in a more buildings are, you know, more people are hurt, more buildings are just in rubble, and that's the result of bombs dropping from planes, United States airplanes. And you know, if this kind of death and pain and suffering, if it happened specifically and only to targeted terrorists, that's one thing. But that's a dream. That's not reality. In real life, real bombing in the real world is quite inaccurate. It's quite imprecise. Civilians do end up being caught in the crossfire. A bomb, you know, we want to drop it on top of a terrorist headquarters, but it could actually end up on top, right on top of a children's hospital. It could end up right on top of a school building. It could end up right on top of people's homes. And that kind of things happens. That happening just once is really tragic. That a bomb intended for terrorists ends up killing families who have nothing to do with terrorism. But the more we bomb, the more of that stuff happens. So the next time you say and think, we need to bomb those terrorists, you know, I think it's important that we think about that statement deeply and realize more what our billions of tax dollars and funding these bombing operations actually do. It does, for a large part, demoralize the enemy, whatever. It does take out terrorists, but in so doing, it also causes a lot of pain and suffering and has a lot of unintended consequences that we might not even realize until way later, until it's too late. So that's my thought for today. Cheers.